So 5 years ago at GSK, we set out really a strong agenda of not just find a few things to do which make us look good, but what are the fundamental things we can change in the way we do business to once and for all align the goals of the organization and the way of thinking in the organization with what we believe society expects of us. Now, there are many areas in which you could have a conversation around a business model of an industry like the pharmaceutical industry, but the one I want to focus on today is around transparency and collaboration. For a very long time, they've been perceived as things the industry doesn't do, doesn't want to do. And I think to some degree, there was a history in the industry of fear around collaboration especially, openness of information, and a mistaken judgment that actually by being more open and more transparent around data, somehow that would destroy the fundamental business model. I think probably the most important areas we tackled was the opening up of intellectual property. So by being the first company to be prepared to put all of our intellectual property in the field of neglected tropical disease into the patent pool, that was really a seminal moment in the company, and I would argue the history of the industry, in terms of acknowledging that you can have different approaches to intellectual property to solve different problems. So tuberculosis is one of the most difficult challenges in the world. We've done exactly the same again. We've screened all of our molecules against tuberculosis. And we're announcing today that we'll publish all of the hits that we've achieved. Now, in this case, we've had far fewer hits, something over about 200 hits within the compound library. So what does that tell you? It tells you tuberculosis is a lot more challenging to find leads. But 200 hits in the public domain tomorrow is 200 more than we had yesterday. We are very transparent about the way in which we report these studies. Not everybody believes that, and even when we do things, people still say we don't do them. So just to reiterate what we do and what we don't do, we do publish every protocol on the web before it starts. So if you want to see any trial that we're running or are about to start, you can see it. And equally, we publish every set of results, whether they are positive or negative. Interestingly enough, it's quite hard to get negative studies published in journals. So if you want to see negative study reports, you need to come to our website. We're announcing that we're going to make available all of the patient-level anonymized clinical trial data from all of our trials. Now, what does that actually mean? It means that we will publish or make available through a web application access so that people can get to see not the trial summary, which you will still see, not our conclusion, which you will still see, but you will have the opportunity to be able to go in and see the raw data at patient level. Now, to give some precision to what we're committing to, first of all the data will be anonymized. It will be impossible for anybody, and that is a really critical point, it will be impossible for any patient to be associated with any piece of data. And the final thing I hope you really do take away from this is that at the core of all of this is an acknowledgement and a massive appreciation for the contribution that individual men and women make as patients and volunteers within clinical research. And I think that by what we're doing in terms of publication or making available of this data is actually fully and properly trying to ensure that their contribution leads to the maximum possible health gain.